is so delightful. Since we know a place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
No, it doesn't show signs of stopping. So I brought a little corn for popping. Now the lights are turned away down low. So let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
When we finally say goodnight, how I hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm.
Now the fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbying. But as long as you love me so,
let it snow,
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 let it snow.
I'm dreaming tonight of a place I love even more than I usually do. And although I know it's a long road back, I promise you
time of the year.
Christmas, everyone. Let's stand up. Let's go ahead and stand up. We want to welcome all of our guests here tonight. I know we got a lot of visitors, a lot of family here. My dad's here somewhere. I don't know where you're at, Dad. But we want to have a time of fellowship and shake some hands, give some hugs, make some people feel welcome, make some friends. Let's do that now.
Well, let's sing a song together. We all know this song, Joy to the World, right? Let's clap.
To introduce someone to you, our pastor, Gary Jared.
Let's pray together. Father, we just want to thank you for your love and your goodness. Lord, as we come together tonight, Lord, to celebrate Christmas, We just look forward to this time. I pray if there's somebody here tonight that doesn't know the joy of Christmas, that before they leave, they would come to the understanding that can truly know what the purpose of Christmas is all about. Again, we thank you and praise you. In Jesus' name we pray. And all God's people said,
amen.
You may be seated. They say Christmas is the most wonderful time of the year. But you know, it's not true necessarily for everybody. For some people, they struggle at this time of the year. There are people who are going through some very difficult times maybe in their life. There's some emotional struggles, heartache, hurt, loneliness. The song that you just heard, beautiful Christmas song, but there's a dark verse in there. There was a man, the man who wrote the song was Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, and he wrote it during the Civil War. You have to understand what was going on in his life at the time he wrote this song. His wife had just died. She had died from a fire. He had a son that was serving in the military who had taken a shot to the shoulder. They didn't even know if he would survive or not. And it was a year later on Christmas that he released a poem called Christmas Bells. And that was the song you just heard. But there's a dark verse that says this, "And in despair I bowed my head. There is no peace on earth, I said, for hate is strong and mocks the song of peace on earth, goodwill to men." There was a man who needed a miracle in his life. He needed some hope. But Henry Wadsworth Longfellow recognized that his hope was not necessarily in this world, but was in a relationship with Jesus Christ. In the very next statement, he says this in that song, "Then pealed the bells more loud and deep. God is not dead, nor does he sleep. The wrong shall fail, the right prevail, when peace on earth, goodwill to men." That miracle came in the form of a baby that was born 2,000 years ago. Luke records it and says this, "Joseph went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem. And Mary gave birth to her firstborn son, and she wrapped him in clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for him in the inn."
child is born to save.
The angel said to the shepherds, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings and great joy, which will be for all the people. For today in the city of David, there has been born for you a Savior who is Christ the Lord." Suddenly there appeared with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men with whom he is pleased."
Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born King of Jews? For we saw his star in the east and have come to worship." When they saw the child with Mary, they fell to the ground and worshiped him. Then opening their treasures, they presented him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you. king would leave his throne so we could
God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
And friend, how can my praises
ever find end through years unnumbered. On heaven's shore, my song shall praise him forevermore.
What the story of Christmas is all about. It's the most wonderful time of the year. And yet, in this most wonderful time of the year, we find ourselves very busy, don't we? I mean, we live such busy, hustle, bustle lives at Christmas time. We get so in such a rush at times that we miss really what the true point of the season is all about. I remember hearing about a lady who was in such a hustle and a hurry, she didn't even have time to get Christmas cards out. You ever been there before? Where you run to the store at the last minute and just grab the last box that's on there and put a stamp on them and mail them out and send them to everybody. And after Christmas, you sit back and say, whew. Boy, that was a busy time. I remember she sent the cards out and she thought, well, I need to find out what I've said in the cards. So she got one of the cards and looked at it and said, just a little note to say that a Christmas gift is on the way. I think there were going to be some disappointed people that got that Christmas card. Can I tell you something? When you think about Christmas gifts, whose idea was this anyways? Who thought of, December the 25th, let's give a gift to everybody? Well, that was God's idea. It was God's idea. See, God brought us into this world. He created man, created us in his own image. Man, when he fell, we were separated from God. There was an emptiness within inside each and every one of us that could never be satisfied. We try to fill it. We try to fill it with stuff and substances and all kinds of material things. And it seems like it never satisfies. And it never will. God couldn't bear the thought of us being separated from him forever and ever and ever. So God sent the very best gift he could. He sent his only begotten son. The Bible tells us that the wages of sin is death. And that's what each and every one of us deserve. We talked about that this morning in our message today. We have a way of kind of judging ourselves and comparing ourselves with everybody else and say, well, I'm not so bad. Well, the standard is in other people. The Bible says the standard is Jesus Christ. And when we look at who Jesus is, the Bible says we all fall short. We all fall short. We miss the mark. Say, how am I supposed to get there? That's all about God. That's what Christmas is about. It's the best gift of all. The wages of sin is death. And then there's a little adversative in there that changed. It turns everything. Three-letter word, but. I love that. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. You know, here we are at Christmas again. I'd hate for you to go through the hustle and bustle, get so in such a hurry that you miss what Christmas is all about. You can experience the true joy of Christmas if you just stop and pause and reflect that God loves you more than anything in this world, and he gave you the best gift of all. Christmas time, we're going to wrap those gifts. But 2,000 years ago, God gave a gift. It didn't have pretty paper or shiny bows on it, but it was wrapped in swaddling clothes and laying in a manger. And he says, here's your gift. It's my only son. Question is this, at Christmas time, have we stopped just to think about what he's done for us and to receive him into our lives? Let me ask you to bow your heads real quick, just for a moment here. If you're here tonight and don't know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, this is what this whole program's about. Once again, we stop and celebrate Christmas. We'll leave here and we'll go on our ways, but you have a decision to make tonight. Have you taken the gift that God has given to you, the best gift of all, his only son? You see, God came upon a divine seek and save rescue mission. He wasn't just a little baby that was born 2,000 years ago. He lived a sinless, spotless life. And then around 30 years of age, he stretched his arms as wide open as he could to show us how much he loved us, and there he died on a cross. Just sang about that, up Calvary's mountain. Friends, he died and he was buried. But let me tell you what the real game changer was. There have been a lot of people that have died for a cause, but there's only one who ever came back to validate his claims, and that was Jesus Christ. He died, he was buried, and then he rose again. And then he offers salvation to whoever will may come. If you're here tonight and don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, I'm going to spend just a moment here. We're going to have a prayer time. We're going to talk to God. That's what prayer is all about. If you've never received him into your life, I'm going to pray a simple prayer here. There's nothing magical or mystical about these words. Really, it's the intent. It's the commitment within your heart, whether you're willing to make that decision tonight and experience true joy at Christmas time. Heads bowed and eyes closed. Maybe say something like this. Heavenly Father, I believe that Jesus died on the cross for my sin. I believe he was buried, and I believe he rose again the third day. And Jesus, right now, the best I know how, I ask you to forgive me of my sin. I ask you to come into my life and be my Lord and Savior tonight. I give you my life to do with it as you please. Now, with heads bowed and eyes closed, I want you to know if you were sincere about that, I guarantee the angels in heaven are singing now and rejoicing over your decision. I think before you leave tonight, you ought to let somebody know. Father, we just thank you for your love and your goodness. We thank you for what Christmas is all about. Father, let us stay in tune. Let us not get caught up in the hustle and bustle, but just to pause and reflect and say thank you for the best gift of all. We thank you and praise you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Yeah.
You know, all throughout Scripture, Scripture tells us, you know, God gave us music. Stay standing. I want you guys to stand up with us. He gave us music. He told us to sing. He didn't even tell us to, if you could sing, sing. He said, everybody sing. He didn't just say sing, but he said sing exuberantly. And that means with unrestrained joy. So we're going to sing a song. And if you don't know it, you can clap along or you can sway or whatever you want to do. But we need your help. So, Connor, are you ready, buddy? You good? Here we go. One, two, one.